Hancock Show. Time for Crazy George. George, what is this?
38 Ford.
That's a 38 Ford.
Yeah, I told you I'm not.
Gee, what kind of chassis is it sitting on?
I don't know. I really don't.
Is it disc brakes?
Yeah.
Is it gas or diesel?
Gas. I think it's a 318 in there.
So, well, you done bought it this way, right?
Yeah.
I'm not going to ask you how much you gave for it, because if it wasn't worth it, you wouldn't have done it.
No. I can't remember right here. I think they gave about, I gave about $5,000 for it, I think. That's not bad, huh?
No, especially when you didn't have to do any of the work.
Well.
But, you know, what everybody wants to know about is, where in the world did you ever come up with this coffin on the back?
It came from Scotland, the 1400.
No way. It looks like it came from Scotland in 1400.
Okay, it looks like it came from Scotland. Well.
No, but is it authentic or somebody just put the thing together?
I built it.
Okay. Now, this is something that you do as a business then, is build these? And
well, I built this one, and people liked it, so I really need to go to Sturgis. My plan next year to go to Sturgis.
Good to see you here. I'm glad to have you down.
See what they think about it.
So you snagged the truck here. Mind if I open it up?
Oh, yeah, help yourself.
So you snagged the truck here to do your coffin delivery business.
Yeah. I just want cab overs to deliver coffins.
Now if you could just get a coffin nose cord.
Yeah.
And hack that off and make a truck cab out of it. And
yeah.
But she's all late model running gear and no air conditioning. Who needs air for old people? Oh, that's right. There it is.
Yeah, there it is.
There's the air conditioning.
That's Bakelite, the body of that.
And then and then the windshields pop out, so what can you ask for?
Well, then the side vents open up. But that fan I put on, it had a kind of a modern, well, one from the 70s. That one's from the 30s, I think. It's rubber bladed and Bakelite.
Well, then you can't hurt yourself.
I had to weld up some holes, and I dummied this up with a rattle can. I painted that piece that kind of almost matched.
Oh, we love rattle cans.
Yeah, that's a rattle can paint job. I never even bought that.
Nice.
Now I can paint this whole car with a rattle can.
Nice job on the metallic flow.
Yeah.
Looks good. All right, thanks, George.
All right, take care.
Enjoy the rest of the show.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to change some stuff on it a little bit.
We'll be right back. Predator sitting in the 59 Chevy. And this is
Ray.
Ray?
Ray Jones.
Ray and his 59 Chevy machine. I gotta say, Ray, this car is so you. We're gonna get a shot of you sitting in the driver's seat and everybody's gonna understand what we're talking about. What do you got in here? Looks like rat, maybe.
Yeah, 427 out of a 69 vet.
Trick flow heads?
Yeah, that was my touch.
Did they touch the cam too?
A little bit.
How bad?
L88.
What does that mean to me?
Pretty decent size cam.
So you stuck the Predator on there.
Yeah.
So obviously with your trick flows and your cam, you've got enough to flow through a Predator.
Oh yeah.
How's it do on drivability as far as the street goes?
Great.
And then
great.
When you stomp your foot into it?
Watch out.
Even better, huh?
Yep. Yeah, it's got a little problem keeping traction.
Well, you just need some bigger tires on the back here.
Yeah, definitely. That's gonna be next.
This car is nice and straight, I see. Mm-hmm. And it looks like it's basically untouched. Like it's never really had anything done to it in its life.
Not really. No, my never been in an accident. It's originally a Southern California car. Like me, a Southern California boy. My dad bought it in 1966. And he used to drag race it down at Lyons back in the day. And
Lyons drag strip.
Yep. It's a Lyons drag strip survivor right here.
Genuine.
Yep.
So it's been through a lot of engines and transmissions and rear ends and.
Yeah. Yeah, it's had quite a few of those. Actually had the stock rear end in it up until a few years ago. And yeah, the interior was done in I think 86, I believe it was.
Nice mirror, I like that.
Yeah, that's another one of my touches. It was my dad's car, and about 7 years ago or so, he had a stroke. And, you know, I grew up with this car. You know, when I was born, I was brought home from the hospital in it. But yeah, it's got a lot of history, a lot of memories.
Where's all the chrome trim?
In the garage.
You ever gonna go back on, or you kind of like it this way?
Yeah, it'll go back on. I gotta, now that I got everything else working right, I gotta do body work.
So you're gonna put it back to being real nice, or?
Yeah, I'm gonna put it back to the color it was when my dad first bought it, tuxedo black. You know, when he got it, it was originally a lowrider, you know, dropped and had the baby moons.
So you're gonna leave it automatic, or you're gonna go back to the stick that it used to be?
No, I'm gonna leave this tranny in it. These trannies have a 4.5-to-1 low first gear. When my dad ran it back in the day, it had 396 in it. I think at one point it pulled high 12s. But, and this motor's a lot nastier than that was, so.
Pretty good for the day.
Yeah.
Why don't you jump in that driver's seat? Or just kind of sit gently in the driver's seat, if you will. Yeah. Ray, that car is you. You are that car. Thanks for your time, buddy.
No problem. Thank you.
Well, everybody seems to be leaving. These guys are getting ready to bug out. RRR. You knew it was coming, right?
At least one a day.
We'll be right back.
chassis are the same as they are. Are they the same as they are for a RAV4? Are they different?
Okay. So they are. Good afternoon, gentlemen.
How you doing?
Jeff Bradshaw with Redneck Restoration's this old truck. And
Jordan,
you are?
Can you? Dwayne.
Dwayne?
We're old guard riders.
What'd you bring in today?
1930 Model A NAS four-wheel drive.
What kind of chassis did you put that on?
Sitting on a Ford Explorer four-wheel drive.
You said Model A and Nash?
Yeah, the front.
That's kind of where they're fused together right here.
The front's a Model A. And the back end, it's 2829. I cut a door in half so it's extended limo. Four-wheel drive. We carry American flags. We do the funerals for all the vets. Army, Air Force, Navy, Marine, Merchant Marine, Coast Guard.
Here in the Rogue Valley.
Right. We've done 400, 500 funerals the past 2 years. The Marines have done over 1,000.
Too many.
And, we meet them at the airport with the flag line and give them an escort, National Guard, whatever. And then we do all the funerals.
Nice.
We build it for the vets, we drive it for the vets. We do the motorcycle escorts, it's a four-wheel drive Ford Explorer.
Okay, engine and everything.
Yeah. Even has its own airbag.
So you get a chance to go four-wheeling?
As soon as I weld it a little more, I don't want nothing falling apart.
Even has an airbag.
Got another 100 wires to cut off of it.
Oh, love the windows here.
Yeah, here.
There's a flag in my head.
Let itself do it.
Whoops.
It's all right.
Now it's all the way at the bottom. Yeah, I love the hand grenades on the front.
I haven't got stopped yet. Just stop traffic one of these here goes. Or you get rid of the car that way. We're going to
wait 5 minutes. What'd you serve in?
I got drafted in 1968. My buddies got killed, so I got out and I went back in and stayed to 81. All right, guys. OldGuardRiders.com.
Okay.
And I'm the president of the Medford Group.
Thank you very much, Joe. And you served in the 82nd Airborne?
Yeah, 13 years.
I saw the sticker back there. All right, Joe. Appreciate the work you're doing. Thank you very much.
Have a good day. God bless you.
Well, that's it. I'm out of interviews. If I'd have been here earlier today, maybe I'd have got some more. But Gary Hubbard's leaving in his 46 GMC. Of course, he's got an updated driveline in it, but beautifully painted with battleship gray and blue and orange all mixed together. And until he ran out of paint. We'll get an interview of him someday because he's pretty much local for me. I'll run across him, do an interview on that truck. But that's it for the Rod-O-Rama 2012 at Josephine County Fairgrounds, Grants Pass, Oregon. So for Redneck Restoration's this old truck, I'm Jeff Bradshaw.
This next one's going to be like solid copper. That'd be great. Or gunmetal blue with nickel-plated rivets. Can you imagine that? Hey, you're not filming me already, are you?
I just now hit record. I just now hit record. Because I don't know that all gets edited out. Oh, yeah, you do.
No,
you do.
I don't talk good.
Just think sawmill.
Yeah,
you know?
Sawmill.
Just
move this door closed.
We do now.
Yeah, for being all original, ain't bad.
I know how to come back with it. Don't you kid yourself.
Okay, well, you got to keep it clean from this point on.
We'll forget it.
It's a family program. Okay, it's time for Crazy George. George, what is this?
38 Ford.
That's a 38 Ford.
Yeah, I told you I'm not.
Yeah.